美国犹他州的警方在一处河谷找到失联将近一个月的中国留学生庄同学，他跟警察说他很冷很害怕。原来这名中国留学生刚刚经历了一场虚拟诈骗。
The cyber kidnappers convinced the victim under duress to take photos of themselves that make it appear they are being held captive and send the photos to their parents.In China, Zhuang's parents equally terrified, unable to reach their son.
诈骗者掌握了留学生家境状况，包括家长工作、资产、孩子就读的学校、宿舍在哪等等，冒充大使馆的工作人员、美国警察、FBI 等单位，要求受害者在独处的环境下交保证金。就这样，庄同学被迫躲起来，而他的父母因此被诈骗了$80,000。
这是我修的结果。
最近这类虚拟诈骗案子不少，诈骗者近期常常锁定外国学生，尤其是大陆生。上海一名家长着急地以为孩子出事了，
视频打通了。
近年来，美国各地也出现了类似案件。
Didn't do what he said. He would kill my mom.
It looked exactly like my sister was calling. It was a man's voice on the other end screaming at me.
You're in that crisis mode, and you immediately want to try to fix it, which in most cases means money.
诈骗分子利用留学生涉世未深，加上和父母相距较远、沟通不畅等因素来诈骗。提醒遇到此类的诈骗，不要轻易付款，并及时与警方联络。TVBS 新闻郑胜伟、陈湘如综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。